Dr. Elizabeth Vanacore from the University of Puerto Rico Mayaguez Department of Geology, and I work as a seismologist at the Puerto Rico Seismic Network. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the different types of waves you find in an earthquake. An earthquake isn't just a simple explosive source event. So what happens when you have an earthquake, you have multiple types of waves produced. There are three major types of waves. One is the P wave, or the primary wave. The second one is the S wave, or the secondary wave. And the third one are the surface waves. Now, these waves have different motions and arrive at different times. And so seismologists like myself can use these arrivals to help locate earthquakes, specifically using the P and the S wave arrival times. Now, I'm going to show you with a slinky some of the basic movements of both P waves and S waves. With a little bit of assistance. Now, spread out on this table, we have a slinky. The first one I'm going to show is the P wave. And the P wave is a compressional wave. Same line as propagation. Or the easy way to show it is the slinky, you pull back, and release, and the slinky is moving back and forth across the table, and the table in line with the slinky. Now, the second wave is the S wave. Now, the S waves, there are something called the S vertical and the S horizontal. So essentially, these are the S waves will move perpendicular to the propagation. So in other words, they'll move a bit more like a snake along the ground. So if it was moving in and out along the plane right the way my hand is moving now, that would be horizontal. If it was moving up and down, that would be the S vertical. To show you what the S horizontal looks, again, pulling the slinky sideways, and they'll bounce back and forth across the table. So those are two of the waves. The third one is the surface waves. And these waves move, they're two different ones. They are Rayleigh waves that move like ocean waves, and Love waves, which are kind of like the shear waves, moving back and forth. And the reason we care about surface waves is because usually surface waves have the largest amplitudes, and therefore they're the ones that are most felt and most destructive. So as far as when an earthquake occurs, these waves all move at different rates. The one that's the rabbit in the race is the P wave. It's the fastest and the first to arrive. However, the P wave also tends to have a smaller amplitude, which means that that's the wave that people don't necessarily feel. Now, the second one in the race are the S waves. It's a little bit slower than the P waves, but not as slow as the surface waves. So the S waves usually tend to have a bit higher amplitude than the P waves. And then the third one in the race, the last one, are the surface waves, which tend to have the largest amplitudes. To show you an example of what this looks like in a seismogram, I have a video. This is of our 6.4 in southwest and from the southwest Puerto Rico sequence that we had in January this year. And on this video, you'll be able to hear and see an event coming in. Now, what does that sound like? So I chose this one because of the differences in time. The further away you get from that location, the more spread out the waves get, because the P wave is faster than the S wave, which is faster than the surface wave. So we have the P wave arriving first, then you have our S wave arriving, and then you see this big packet of waves coming through. These are the surface waves. So I've already shown you one of a more distant or regional event where the P wave, the S wave, and the surface wave have separated. However, what does that look like for a local event, like we measure here at the Puerto Rico Seismic Network? Well, the reality is, if you're looking at a local event, the race hasn't really started, really, much yet. So they haven't had much spreading out of the different waves due to different velocities. So essentially, you have the P wave and the S wave and the surface waves are very close to each other. So what happens over multiple seconds, over tens of seconds or hundreds of seconds in distant earthquakes occurs within just a few seconds. So what I'm showing you here is the 6.4 event recorded in Aguadilla. Now, the event itself only goes up to about 1,500 or 1,600 seconds on this slide. And then you can see some of the replicas or the aftershocks coming in afterwards. You can hear in this video, essentially, that 6.4, we heard before in the wilderness, you heard a hit for the P wave, a hit for the S wave, and then a rumble for the surface waves, all you really hear is that first big boom for that 6.4. And that's because the waves are all very close to each other in time. And it would be very difficult to spread that out and make it audible for a human to hear. Because in order to make seismic signals audible, you actually have to speed it up. This video is 500 times faster, the other one was 200 times faster. So with that, I just want to do a quick recap. Help me remember what I told you is there are three major types of waves, P waves, S waves, and surface waves. The P waves are faster than the S waves, which are faster than the surface waves. And the largest amplitude waves tend to be the surface waves and therefore and also the most destructive waves. They're the ones you feel the most during an earthquake. So what I want to remind you, because you're already feeling these earthquakes, is one, drop, cover, and hold on. And then wait for the shaking to stop. And then once the shaking stops, take another deep breath, look around your surroundings, and decide what you need to do next. Thank you. Have a good day.